Hello and welcome to Vocal Flaps YouTube channel. Grafana is an excellent platform for data visualization. It differs from many others by one simple ability. Grafana dashboard can combine data sources that are traditionally considered to be from different digital universes. To give you a few simple examples, Grafana dashboard can combine analytics from SQL database with a live camera feed and on top can seamlessly add user data entering features, like on this dashboard, where I can enter some parameters and immediately get a recalculated graph. In this video, I will share one more non-conventional data source that brings value to the end users. I'm talking about having an RSS and ATOM news feed on your Grafana dashboard. Hopefully, after watching this video, you will be able to assemble your newsfeed visualization in no time. Let's go! RSS and ATOM are two slightly different formats designed for the same purpose. In most cases, they are XML files that contain every part a web resource has ever posted in chronological order. In my opinion, having all updates in one place in chronological order should be considered a superpower, for the simple reason that newsfeed allows you to access only new information and only when you have time for that. Almost all worth following web resources provide RSS or ATOM feeds now. For instance, Volkov Labs has a blog on Medium. I search the internet for Medium RSS feeds, which brings me to that instruction page. I want a publication feed, so I'm going to use the following template. The name is Volkov Labs, hence my link should be medium.com/feed/Volkov Labs. Here is what I will see if I open the link with my browser. Now, after finding a feed from the resource I want, I'm ready to set up my Grafana dashboard to display this feed in a readable format. Here is what it's going to look like once I'm done. Let me walk you through the configuration steps. First, I need to install the RSS ATOM data source in my Grafana from Marketplace, which is under Configuration Plugins menu. Search for RSS ATOM and hit Install. After that, I need to set up a data source. It could be done by hitting the Create a RSS ATOM data source button or using Configuration Data Source menu. Here, name could be anything. I will enter cool blog. Feed URL is the place where I specify the link that I figured a minute ago. It is medium.com/feed/Volkov Labs. Click save and test. Great, I'm connected. After the data source is set up, I need to decide which visualization panel to use in order to display my feed on the dashboard. As you no doubt know, a data source is a gate between your data storage and visualization. So I just set up data source. Now it's time for visualization. RSS ATOM data source works excellently with dynamic text panel. Install it using the familiar route, configuration plugins. Search for the dynamic text and hit install. Now when I create a panel, I can select dynamic text from the drop-down list. Next, in the data source drop-down, I select the cool blog data source. Select item for return drop-down, table view to ensure the data is flowing. Here you go. The XML file generated by Medium website is right here in a table format. I want to use the publication date for sorting to have articles displayed in chronological order. So let me transform it from the text format to the date format. For that, on the Transform tab, I select Convert Field Type. Field pop date as time and input format as follows. I'm very close to being done with my task. So what I have so far is the dynamic text panel connected to RSS ATOM data source, which translates the news feed on the fly, meaning transforms an XML file into a columnar format. Yes, the columnar format is more readable than XML, but still, I could make it a little better by using markdowns and handlebars. In my case, I will use the following text to transform data into a nice, human-eye-friendly visualization. Note that I use the column headers, which are the same as element names in the curly brackets right here. Let's switch from the table view to see the results. It's looking much better like this. Now I can save and apply, resize and rearrange if needed. Voila! I have the RSS feed on my Grafana dashboard. If you have your cloud service provider RSS on your dashboard, you will be ahead of the game by instantly knowing when a problem arises. Your dashboard can combine system metrics like performance, latency, memory, and any other with news feeds coming from Azure, AWS, Balena Clouds, etc. Since the data source supports both format RSS and ATOM, it can be leveraged for any news feed, from business to sports, from financial to cryptocurrency news, and any other. Here is another example from the Bitcoin trade, where the dashboard displays the Bitcoin news along with its candlestick graph. Now please go to the description box below to find links to everything I mentioned. Remember to like this video since it helps this channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.